Hello everyone, Hisa here, and today I am going to rake up my yard. Doors. So today, like I said, I am going to be raking up my yard because, if you're in the know, which you probably should, the Nicole storm is, kind of on the horizon right now. So a whole bunch of stuff is in my yard, leaves, straws, all that stuff. It's not really that bad of damage. It's mostly just the yard work. And thank God that the didn't actually hit the house in any way. So what we'll be doing here today is that I'm going to be raking my yard, especially since with all these leaves around here, there's going to be like a whole bunch of critters. And yeah, that's pretty much it. But before I actually continue this, I would just like to show you damage. Yeah, that is really a lot of damage. So first things first, right? Something I would like to show you. Will not really show you, but the first thing to actually get done here is the corners of the house. And the reason why, you should probably get like the areas where basically what I'm saying is you should get the leaves that are closest to your house because, bugs. Bugs are like all in these leaves, like right here. There's some a whole bunch of little craters in there. So, it is strongly advised to get all these things here. Because you do not want all these bugs just, in your area. Especially since that is illegal. Since, they're on private property, So, also, make sure to also, dust off your, rake once in a while, No. Hey, London. Neighbors. Gonna be not that much commentary here because the talk about while you're ripping out the yard. I guess some people have that skill. Some people You just have the skill to talk about anything. So, you know? Like, they could think about something like, I don't know, in midair, and then they could just ramble and ramble on about it. You know? While actually just, you know, like you're just saying, like, a whole bunch of fuzz, you know, stopping to think, like, people could really just think of, like, a topic even that they're not even familiar with, and then just go off it. You know? That's a skill. And I do not have that skill. I would like to improve on it. Also, another thing I'd like to talk about, or something I'd like to talk about, is you know, editing, right? Because, you know, if I'm actually going to edit, this entire yard is probably going to take like 3 minutes, right? So, you know, just me kind of just, well, you guys just kind of looking at me in the yard and stuff. And but I will kind of like place this down like on my, on a table, right? So you can actually, or well, I don't have to keep holding this phone. But yeah, showing you this, it's a bit cleared up, gonna, you know, get some of the other areas, but right now I'm focusing on these first since they're the closest to my house. And then we have this area. As you can see here, my rock. And see there, all those bugs, all those little critters, all those things moving around, all those things didn't see that. Winkers. Winker activity right there. I can say that for sure. This is why pesticides was invented. Actually, those are more mainly, you know, just used for crops and such, but you know. Million ways to ride. Yeah, see all those things leaving? There must be one fact. A lot of bugs. They like the darkness. You know? The heart of darkness. You gotta understand that if you know eating grit like that. What I'm saying is, the reason why these bugs are here in the first place is because the reason why these bugs are out here in the first place is because, you know, you get a whole bunch of stuff, you know, like a whole bunch of homes, you know, some have a shelter, right? But I guess they don't really care whether it's sheltered or not. But still, though, you know, like it provides a right amount of bugs and stuff. I would definitely say, I, Alexander Mathis, would definitely say that it's really just a matter of, you know, they don't really care if it provides darkness and they can properly hide under it, because it also, it does provide shelter, because, you know, bigger bugs and bigger, like, bigger predators like birds and stuff. Cause, like, there's a whole bunch of freaking birds like that one, so yeah, it protects them from them. I would definitely say, you know, if I was a bug, you know, this may, you know, sound kind of, I don't know how you're gonna call this. Because I'm not a bug, right? And I'm probably being biased since I am a person, right? But, you know, I would try to just, you know, find my own thing, right? You know what I mean? You know, be independent, you know, not live off another man's property. No. I am an independent bug. I am an independent insect, alright? And I understand that bugs be bugging sometimes, but, like, come on. Relying on someone else's home for your benefit, like you. Have they not have no moral? Do they not have no honor? As someone said. Gonna be a whole lot of things out here since my sisters they have like all the stuff, like they have like tennis balls, racket balls, ball rackets, don't like sword, you know, a lot of stuff. So there's gonna be a lot of like in fire in here, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? And I don't know. Just have to... this stuff because I want kind of, you know, put my plan here. Well, not my plan, but you know, my phone. Yeah, but. Alright. So I'm going to place part of camera here so you can like see this area. So I'm going to start raking this side now. Take off my coat really quick because it is actually not really the best time to have an entire coat on. Also, if you hear barking and stuff, that's my neighbor's phone. Just, you know, just vibing. Just vibing. As people like to say. It should be a better temperature.
your objective is get as much stuff away from yourself as possible. So, you know, animals don't reside there. And then you realize that you have to pick this up later, right? So it wouldn't be advised like just throwing them like all the way out there in the back, because then a lot of bugs will form there and you have to get rid of the stuff. So a technique is just, you know, moving it at least like 3 feet away from, like, you know, at like some point, like what you would consider like not near your home that much, and then like just start wrapping or raking it. Another technique, advice. If you have like, actually I'll show you this. Now, if you have like big piles like that, don't like try to, you know, like rake it up like with that, right? Because like the rake, right? It's a rake, and that's how I broke like many of my rakes before. So just like try, you know, like if you're trying to move like a large lump of like hay or something like that, then just like, you know, scrape off like the top of it and like keep like scooping it up like little by little and move it that way, rather than just like trying to scoop it up, because you're going to have like a big chance of breaking it over.
Also, I just have to say, today is Veterans Day. So if you know a veteran, or you have like a veteran as a grandparent, or, you know, close to one, no one, just tell them a happy Veterans Day. And to me, happy Veterans Day to all my veterans out there.
Yeah,
there should be like a blue one, like a insurance or something like that.
Seeing the bugs out here when you're sleeping, would you rank them up?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, okay. All right.
sticks.
Oh, branches.
Yeah, that's the problem going into the city or something. I don't know.
Four of us. All we used to get one section of the yard.
Yeah.
Oh, you didn't see fun?
I see it now. I'm talking about it.
You want to do it? You want to do it?
Inductible.
do not see that. The second, what I was about to say is this, right? This is like one of those things that, like, I'm so perfect, right? Because I'm just like, taking. Wood. Well, not just any wood. Rotted wood. The difference between wood and rotten wood, if you don't know, is that rotted wood is easier to break and it just becomes mushy. Or not mushy, but it becomes the same fragileness as a mushroom.
reporting in. Section. Section 2 is completed. Now it is time for me to move on to section 3. If you can see that, it is over there. And section 4, which is over there. So all I have to do is just rip up these few bits and probably get a few behind the yard, which I would call that section 5. And then it should be good.
As I was saying, mother fricker indeed. There was a freaking ant here, but what I was about to say, this is another one. You know? Surely it is a masterpiece. Yeah, and that's another thing I like to say. Like I said, whole lot of birds, whole lot of bugs. I don't know if this is a good sign or not, but I am starting to smell smoke. I don't know where, but I should probably just say that, just in case.
I can see.
All right.
So I just got a notification that my battery is almost low. So I'm gonna have to hurry this up with the last section four. All right, I'm just gonna include the, maybe I'm gonna do shred. Section four will be my last section. And I'm gonna do that quick, and I'm gonna show everyone a few mates and lasses. So I'm gonna make sure that, and I'm gonna show all your mates and lasses my progress that I have made. Then yeah, see you guys in the air or something. You see this? I don't even know that. My lashes
God has blessed us today. Okay, I don't really know what I'm saying here, but what I am saying here is I'm done. See that? No, it's not perfect in any way, shape, or form. But if I was really gonna, you know, break up all this stuff, it was gonna take me like an extra hour or so. And here's the guard, behind the shed. That's where my dog was buried. He's drowning. This is the swing playhouse, whatever you call it. That right there, that is section 4. I got done with that. This is section 3. Over there is section 2. And right there, section 1. Yeah, it's been a ride with you or me, something. And thank you guys for watching this video. I'm going to have to get my family to help me pick all this stuff up. So see you later. Kisai out.